Hey everybody, what's up? My name is Graham Uhelski, and we are going to be talking about anamorphic lenses on today's video. I'm trying to shoot literally every aspect of this video with the anamorphic adapter that I recently picked up. It's an older adapter, and there isn't another one of these things on the internet right now for sale. Like, I swear, I think I got the last one of these things on the entire internet. And yeah, these things are kind of hard to find. So if you're on eBay and you see one of these SLR Magic adapters pop up for a decent price, it's worth picking up. I'm having a lot of fun with this thing. I'm pairing it up with the vintage Nikon Nikkor lenses right here. The anamorphic adapter has 52 millimeter rear thread, so you can just screw the anamorphic adapter directly on the lens. I'll be the first to admit that I've faked anamorphic on pretty much every short film I've ever done. The technique where you just shoot in a 240 or a 235 aspect ratio in camera, it gives you that, you know, that scope look that we all like, but at the same time, it's not really doing anything that an anamorphic lens would normally do other than creating the aspect ratio. Optically, you're getting a compressed image, and you go on the computer after you've shot your footage and you de-squeeze it in whatever your NLE software is. I'm using Premiere Pro. It's a fairly simple process, but it's just amazing to see how much additional optics I can get out of all my lenses just by slapping this anamorphic on top of it. Shooting with an anamorphic adapter has its advantages. You get optical increase on all of your lenses. You get like a horizontal field that just stretches out so much more, and you're able to use your full sensor. It's kind of amazing. Not to mention the flares look beautiful. You have some limitations with this adapter. The lenses, you can't be shooting wide open with this adapter. You're gonna have really blurry, just not pretty images. So you're gonna wanna stop down to 5.6. This lens does not have the oval bokeh. That is one drawback of this thing that you are not gonna have much luck with. It does have the beautiful flares. You do get a little bit of barrel distortion, but you're not gonna be seeing that oval bokeh. One of the greatest things about this adapter is it's pretty light, and coupled with one of these vintage lenses, which are also fairly light, it actually balances pretty well on the Mazda Air 2, which, to be able to say that you can have a fully capable 6K cinema camera with an anamorphic lens on a gimbal, I mean, like, what excuse do I have anymore to not make a film?